Ironstone gravel soils are often considered by grain growers to be problematic, but a GRDC investment is enabling the University of Western Australia to combine chemistry and physics to help scientists and growers understand potential water and nutrient absorption by these gravelly soils in an effort to increase crop profitability.
Ironstone gravel, in contrast to other gravels, is porous, which means they have a pathway for water, which then can transport as a conveyor belt, for example, macronutrients, micronutrients. They can store water, they can hold it and release it again. You can see these tiny little bubbles. This is our ironstone gravel, still intact. And once those erode and mix with the soil, we get our ironstone gravel soils.
Around 9% of Australia's cropping soils contain ironstone gravels, mainly in southern WA and South Australia. They're commonly aluminium, silica or iron-based.
The more you go east, the less percentage of ironstone gravels our soils contain.
Scientists are determining if regional distribution of ironstone requires differences in how they're treated, along with absorption mechanisms.
They are more like this kind of brick with a lot of pores. So they are porous with pathways basically then for the water and the gases to flow. How they infiltrate, we don't know in which pore sizes the water sits. Can it be released? Is it trapped in there and plants can't even use that? Do microbes, for example, colonize these gravels? Are they building a hub for microbes, for example, that can sustain then the dry and hot summer periods? These are specific questions we want to ask and to resolve within the GRDC-funded project.
In addition to high-tech science, unique geological expertise and technology from the mining industry is being applied to the Ironstone Gravel Project, aiming to deliver practical and ultimately profitable outcomes to grain growers.
This is a groundbreaking research, never looked in this detail before from an agriculture perspective. And this is the beauty that we can harvest some of the results from the mining industry and use it and apply it into the agricultural context as well.
The project has just kicked off. In the lab, researchers are analysing samples, sizing gravel, and running hydrology tests. Is water tightly bound or can it be released? All of this requires some heavy-duty technology.
The CAT scanners, we're using nanosims, a lot of electron microscopy to understand the fine details and the mechanisms that actually are behind these processes.
So inside the X-ray machine, we have a piece of gravel at the moment. It's currently sitting in water, and we can watch as the water penetrates into that piece of gravel. So this is just a three-dimensional representation of the piece of gravel. Cut through the middle. This is approximately 8 millimetres. I don't think anyone's studied soils and gravels in this amount of detail before, and there's heaps that we can find out. There's a lot of information on the properties of the soil that we can ascertain from these studies.
We want to provide clear advice for the farmer based on their region, which is a really beneficial ironstone gravel. We want to advise them on fertilizer, on water management, to better understand their soils.
Potential research outcomes could be to increase crop yield by using more or perhaps less fertilizer on gravel soils, or determine whether lower yields are the cost-saving reality with these kinds of soils. Either way, growers are set to benefit from the findings.
I've driven through the southwest and a lot of the wheat belt areas, and you see all the fields growing there, and it's great to actually be sitting here in the lab knowing that you're going to be contributing to some of the benefits of growing better crops.
I think we have not closely looked enough so far to our gravel soils. We know they are cropped, we know crops are growing in there, the roots love to go in between of the gravels as well. So let's wait 1 or 2 years to get the real basics of these gravels and then look for the advice that they are waiting. But I think there is some potential that we can increase the yields for the future.
Go to the description bar below for the latest information, links and resources.